Alrighty, what we're looking for is a big stone grumpus face and a bug snack called a pinkle. Let's look around. La, 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 la. there would be the work of the ancient stone grumps, a civilization from over 5,000 years ago. All that's left of them is statuary and some puzzling mechanisms. Unlike the desert grumps, these folks didn't preserve their dead. In fact, the writer thinks they would sacrifice him to the bug snacks, like an offering to the gods and whatnot. This means bug snacks may be a more lasting legacy than any of the stuff they built. That's a good one. You might have noticed Pinkle statues scattered around here. These must have been an important food source to the ancient grumps. Well, I was hoping to find a camp of some sort, maybe a corpse or two. But oh well, there's plenty more spots to check out. Let's head back to Snacksburg for now.
Charwy, just follow Papa's pointer. Or don't. That's fine, too. We're off to a bit of a slow start. It went so easy with Sprout, I just don't know what's going wrong now. Maybe Sprout can help. I'm sure he can show Charwy the ropes. What do you say?
Sprout to lead Charwy back to my barn.
Paddle, 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 pa
Charwee's a good boy, yes he is.
Well, it's a start. But I'm a long ways off from teaching them to spell out, "We love you, Papa." Why, I have to cover myself in sauce every morning just to get them to pay attention to me. But that's just the way it goes. You pour every little bit of love you got into somebody and you just hope they notice.
Yeah. Tropica bug.
Snacky ree. Weenie worm.
Chee-poo.
Hey there, bestie. We've got a new target. Cromdo's back in town. I know that greedy crumbag has some juicy dirt. I'm not talking about his pathetic little lies or scams either. I'm sure you'll find something good. Don't let me down, bestie.
Another fine day behind us.
Nothing yet. Think something might be wrong with the soil. Too dry or maybe too wet. Either way, something needs fixing. Why don't you fetch me a big old fibrous bug snack, like a spuddy? I got a plan.
Nothing like a campfire.
Nothing like getting toasted.
Snack. Snack.
Another fine day behind us.
Thank you. Everybody, come on and do the wiggle with me. Do the wiggle, do the wiggle with me. I do the wiggle, do the wiggle, do the wiggle with me. Yeah! There? Is somebody there?
You didn't hear anything, pal. You got that? Not a single peep. All right, I could use some practice. They'll be interviewing me every day when I'm a gazillionaire. Business king, sales savant, future CEO of Starbucks, the one, the only, Crondo Face! You ever smell the future, kid? Huh? I can tell you, Lisbeth stank of opportunity. She came on TV talking big about this new superfood, and I wanted in. So I quit my dead-end job and followed that stench of possibility. I used to go door-to-door selling gruel to grandmas. Paid on commission, for grump's sake. What do I think of? Delicious! Irresistible! Marketable! They're gonna catapult me straight to the top of Money Town, baby! Yeah, I tried to make use of what Lisbeth didn't need anymore, and Befika didn't like that. Yeah, she went and told everyone that I'm a thief. I was salvaging! That's a community service, pal! But Befika planted evidence in my hut, said I stole her diary. So I did what any honest grump would do. I ran. Ooh, don't get me started. Everyone here thinks she's so great, such a fantastic leader. But I know the truth. She came here to stroke her ego and get Egabel her fix. The rest of us were just disposable. That's Elizabeth Megafig. When push came to shove, she abandoned us. I gotta confess, I was thinking about sailing home after things got hairy. But when I went looking for our boat, it was gone. There's only two grumps missing. You do the math. I bet Liz and Egg are living large in New Grump City by now. Yeah, I get it, pal. I'm not the nicest grumpus around. I learned early on that life is like a box of trash. You always know what you're gonna get. Trash. Just go check out where the boat was. See what you think of Lisbeth after that.
Look at you. How many bug snacks have you had? Hey, In my professional medical opinion, I am perfectly healthy. We're all eating bug snacks, and we're all fine, so why are you getting on my case?
I'm just worried, Bill. You're not acting like yourself.
You mean I'm not miserable? I found a way to make myself useful and happy, to finally take some control over my life, and you're just upset because it doesn't involve you!
I'm not upset. You don't need me anymore. That's great. Go be with Bluesty.
Maybe I will.
How's it going?
OMG! That explains why he's always so jealous of Wiggle. Why would he even hide that? It almost makes him kind of likable.
Another fine day behind us.
Sweet.
I know you've been spying on me, Beth. You keep out of my business, or I'll...
Or you'll what?
You're the one keeping secrets. You can't touch this.
You think I'm the only one who's sick of your Gossip Girl shtick, huh? Sooner or later, you're gonna be back in your cave all by yourself.
Whatever. At least then, I wouldn't have to hear your slimy voice.
You heartless monster! Stop burying the little ones!
You mind your own business. Besides, I thought you wanted more bug snacks.
You know that's not what I meant, and that's not gonna work anyhow.
That's so. Well, you go and let me know when your pets are expecting.
I will!
Oh my.
What's going on, Wiggle?
Hi!
How you doing? That's not for me. No, you go and feed that to Philbo. Then, hole up by the outhouse for a spell. When his business is done, gather up the fertilizer. You know, night soil, waste, spud cruds. Mom, don't make me get crude now.
Wiggle, 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 wiggle.
Oh, hello!
Spuddy.
Oh. Awesome!
Aw, thanks for the gift, buddy. Though, suddenly, I'm feeling nature call. Sorry, gotta go!
Hey, how's it going?
Hoo-wee!
That stink could raise the dead. Whew! That's bound to be potent enough for my soil. Thanks, stranger.
Yeah? Hey, pal, I got a business opportunity for you. I got a tip that Triffany found some sort of treasure map while she was digging around. They say it'll lead to a huge bug snack. Imagine what a snack that size is worth! I was thinking of taking that map off her paws. That's where you come in. Get me a bug snack so delicious that Triffany would die for it, and we'll trade! Then we'll split the profits 50-50. I clearly said 50.
Hello, Triffany.
Oh, hi there.
Charmallows give off an unusual signal. I believe they may be key to the Grumpinati surveillance system, though I'm not yet sure how. Their signal should be safely contained inside my stomach.
Whoa, Snorp Dog, you got the radio working? Let's put some jams on!
Not now, Chandler. The radio is... it's broken.
Popsicle! 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 Popsicle!
Popsicle! Popsicle!
Quickly, feed me the charmallows. With that blind spot in place, I can safely return to Snacksburg. Meet me outside. The sky seems clear of danger. I suppose it's now or never.
Whoa. Snorfy's ready to go? All right, dog, let's do this.
In just a moment, Chandlo. You've been an invaluable ally. I'm even tempted to call you a friend, but quietly so I'm not overheard.
Bro, if I didn't think it'd crush you like a tin can, I would hug the grump out of you. Oh, what the grump. Here it comes!
What expert hugging that is! You do that hug!
All right, let's get out of here! Race you back to town, Snorp Dog!
Please don't make me run with you, Chandlo. I'll go weak in the knees.
If you're not up for it, I could always carry you.
No, that's quite all right.
Your loss. See you back in town, bro!
Chandlo!
Africa. To what do I owe the honor?
I'm just curious what you think you're doing here.
What am I doing? I'm working the counter. Cromdomart's back in business, baby.
Don't act all innocent. If you start running scams again, I'll know.
Yeah, because you know everything. And here's what I know. You're not better than me, Beth. Nobody likes all your snooping around.
I don't care what they think about me, as long as I make sure you get what you deserve.
Don't I always? Are you going to buy something or what?
Yeah, I'll take a tall snack water extra fizz.
Coming right up.
Bro, come check this out! Philbo told me you were living here, and I thought, you know what this place needs? Walls! It's my bad for not finishing it in the first place, though. I was gonna have it ready in time for you, but then all that stuff happened. But sooner or later, Chandlo gets the job done! Enjoy your walls, dog!
Buddy? Whoa.
Ooh, gonna quiz me, dog? I'll crush your questions. Chandlo Funk Bun. I lift. It's a way of life, bro. Anything that needs to go up. Logs, buildings, balls, Snorpy. I'll get them there. If I want to push my limits, I gotta go somewhere extreme. I heard nobody comes back from this island. Sounds like a challenge to me. Hey, I'm always looking out for Snorpy. I know roughing it isn't his style, but there's no way I was coming here without him. I know what you mean, dog. We're like the sky and the sea. Been together since the dawn of time. Bug snacks are strong. Like a primal kind of strong. Like they own this place, and I gotta respect that. Bro, Snacksburg was a disaster without Lizbert. I couldn't stop all the fighting with lifting or wisdom. I gotta keep things chill for Snorpy. He's got a lot of that social anxiety. Lizbert is top dog, you feel me? She really inspires me to test my limits. But that's about it. I'm really tighter with Agabelle. Agabelle's a sweetie. She was always looking out for me. Showed me how to stay safe while still pushing my limits. She was always pushing herself way harder. Yeah, she asked me to train her. Surprised the grump out of me, because she really wasn't built for that kind of stuff. We'd go running every morning and lifting after lunch. Though she would get real down on herself sometimes. But she never gave up, and I respect that. I wish I could tell you. Those two were strong together. I can't think of anything that could take them down. They gotta be okay out there. Somewhere. Bro, that's not... just... dope. Anyway, I recorded Agabelle's progress while we were working out. She shared some pretty private stuff. Maybe it'll help you bring her back to us. Don't let me down, bro.
Bungle, bungle, bungle.
A great job, buddy. But hey, don't forget to take care of yourself. In fact, maybe you should turn in early today and just relax. Something's wrong, buddy. We better take a look.
Saw something real spooky walk right into town.
I thought it was a grumpus at first, but like something about it was wrong.
Was this creature wearing a crown by any chance?
Or was it perhaps holding some sort of ceremonial dagger?
What? No, no, nothing like that. It looked kind of normal until it...
It turned into a bunch of bug snacks and like scattered.
Frankly, I find that hard to swallow.
What a load, Biff. Not enough drama around town for you lately, huh?
Zonk off, Cromdo. Unlike you, I don't lie for a living.
Oh, wow. So tell me then, what were you doing skulking around at midnight? Breaking into huts? Again?
I seen it too. And this time I know it's not just one of my nightmares.
Get some grumpin' sleep, Gramble.
I can't! Not with all of y'all around here with your hungry mouths!
Don't take this the wrong way, darling, but you are a bit high-strung. A little beauty sleep would do you wonders.
Maybe then you'd finally let us eat a few pets!
You say that again! Don't get off me! Stop.
Whoa! Hey, chill the grump out, bros.
There's no need for all that. If what Gramble and Befika are saying is true, there's gotta be some physical evidence left behind, yeah?
Indeed. We should sweep the perimeter and keep watch in case the creature returns.
Good idea. Buddy, do you think you can scope out the restroom? You know, find out what they saw?
Want to get out of town for a hot minute or two. Let things cool down. Judging by history, if this keeps up, we're due for a fist fight.
you found what you were looking for? All right, I'll call everybody together. Well, what did you find?
Well, that's... I reckon there's got to be some other explanation.
Cram it, Wambone. We got a genuine monster on our paws.
Monster's a bit of a prejudicial term, don't you think? I'd call it more of a cryptid or undiscovered animal.
It's no animal, darling. We're witnessing the queen of bug snacks in action. She's given us a warning!
Oh, that is absurd. Which is more likely, that a so far unseen giant bug snack politely left a note on our door, or that this is some form of coordinated gaslighting by the Grumpernut...
What's more likely, dear, is that you've watched far too many movies.
But at least my theory has scientific data behind it, whereas you haven't even drawn one chart.
I was top of the charts, thank you.
Whoa. You know what? Let's split the difference, eh? You're both wrong.
What does it even matter? Whatever it is, it wants us dead.
Between this and the earthquakes, Snacksburg's becoming pretty unlivable.
I hate to say it, bro, but I regret coming down from the mountain. Me and Snorpy were a lot safer before we came back.
Same goes for me and my little ones.
No. We shouldn't split up again. We're better off if we're all here together.
That might have been true when Lisbert was around, but those days are long gone.
You don't know that. She might come back.
Yeah, don't hold your breath, pal.
Face it, Philbo. Without Lisbert, all we have is you.
That's not true. Listen, I don't know why Lisbert put me in charge, but I do know this. None of you were really happy out there alone. We don't have Lisbert, but we have each other. Maybe if we try, we could all add up to one of her.
I guess you're not wrong.
So we're all staying in town then?
Seems like it. As long as we can watch each other's backs.
If we're gonna make it, we need everybody here. Floofty and Sheldar are still out there, and who knows if they're safe.
If you must find Floofty, according to the tracking device I placed on them, they're out by Boiling Bay.
And last time I saw Sheldar, she was meditating in the Sizzling Sands. But don't forget about Agabelle. If she's not with Lisbert, we gotta find her.
We will, Chandlo. And once we do, we'll throw a big welcome back party. How does that sound?
Oh,
okay.
Great! Now, let's go get some sleep.